Well, Joe Biden's promised battle against COVID-19 has begun in earnest. The US president has used his first full day in office to unveil a national pandemic plan as he warned America's death toll will top 500,000 people in the next month.
As the sun rose over a new dawn in America, President Joe Biden began his first full day in the White House with a prayer.
Through Jesus Christ, our Lord.
He's already gotten rid of the previous tenant's red button that summoned a butler with a Diet Coke, and he'd probably throw out his predecessor's COVID-19 plan too, but he claims one doesn't exist, as millions of vaccine doses sit waiting in storage.
The rollout has been a dismal failure thus far.
Today, President Biden unveiled his strategy.
This executive order I'm signing is strengthening the supply chain.
To fight what he calls the greatest operational challenge America has ever faced.
Our national strategy is comprehensive. It's based on science, not politics. It's based on truth, not denial. And it's detailed.
Under Biden's plan, he'll fast-track vaccinations by setting up 100 community centres in places like stadiums, allow more health workers and pharmacies to give the jab, and ask all Americans to wear a mask for the next 99 days. Anyone flying to the US must also get a negative test.
There are moments in history when more is asked of a particular generation, more of ask of us as Americans than other times. We are in that moment now. Because the health of the nation is literally at stake.
And as he declared science is back, so too is Dr. Anthony Fauci.
You feel like you're back now?
I think so.
The leading expert had been sidelined by the previous president amid a strained relationship.
But it was very clear that there were things that were said, be it regarding things like hydroxychloroquine and other things like that, that really was uncomfortable because they were not based on scientific fact.
Not anymore.
It is somewhat of a liberating feeling.
Today, Joe Biden warned Americans that the memorial held here at the National Reflecting Pool won't be the last one. Next month, the death toll is expected to pass 500,000.
But at least now, one of the biggest losses of American life is finally being taken seriously.
It's COVID, 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 COVID.
COVID, we're COVID, in a national COVID, emergency, and it's time we treat it like one.
Eamon Ashton-Atkinson for 10 News First, Washington.